This is the second version for my 3D printed guitar tuners, if you've watched the previous video. In a minute I'll show you all the things going on inside, but before that I'd like to ask that if you do enjoy my videos and you like, you know, design things, 3D printing, and so on, then maybe you might consider hitting that subscribe button on the bottom. I actually started improving on the first version. I made a couple of changes, I made it stronger, added another place for a screw, but I started to realize that the first version had so many problems that it'll just be smarter to make a new version. Anyways, the first thing you would notice is the size difference. The newer one is a lot slimmer, and it's stronger, believe it or not, and it has a lot less parts to deal with. For this version, I had all the parts kind of hold each other together. And there's one piece here that locks them all. And you see that they're really thick, so they don't come apart. But for this one, I realized that the inside parts can be held in with the screws when I screw it down onto the headstock. The previous version was really hard to 3D print due to all the overhangs and the details. The newer one is much easier to print. First of all, this gear is a lot stronger, and the threads on this worm gear are set at a 45 degree angle, so it'll be way easier to print. I've actually made two versions for this gear. One of them has two threads and the other has one thread. The one with two threads has less of a chance of failing because it splits the load between both of the threads, but on the other hand there is more torque force on this shaft. If there's one thread, there's a higher chance for the thread itself to fail, but there is less torque on the shaft. Also, this part of the tuner, it kind of looks cool that it's opened up and everything, but after lots of use, it starts to wobble. I made sure that the new one is fully enclosed from all sides, so it would be way more stable and it needs less material. The last thing you might notice is I started working with a logo. Yeah, it's kind of an inside joke. Let's see if you could figure it out. And this guy is supposed to be a play button. The assembly for the second version is super fast. I mean, look how much time it takes me to assemble the first one in comparison to this new version. Printing them is much easier and much faster. There's no need for supports, all the angles are right, all the parts are smaller, and there are less parts. Last thing I need to do is test them out. I actually didn't test them yet, I really hope they work. Alright, I fixed two of them into this headstock. Notice that the screw holes are not in the center, so there will be room to put the tuners next to each other. This one is an acoustic guitar with steel strings. The previous one works with plastic strings, a classical guitar, so testing nylon strings would be redundant. This one has one thread and this one has two threads. Wish me luck! Ouch! It looks like the gear broke, so let's try the next one. Well, it got a good stretch. It does play, but not enough. I'm gonna try to use some maintenance grease on these gears, the same grease that I use on my printers, and I hope it'll work. Okay, I put it back all nice and greased up. I replaced the broken tuner, and let's try again. It works! It works! Okay, so apparently plastic wins steel. They work great, just don't stretch them too much, or this would happen. If you want to print one for yourself, I will share these files. I'm going to leave a link in the description. Also, I'd like to mention that a fellow YouTuber sent me a bronze casting of these tuners. So you don't miss out on the next video, make sure that you are subscribed. See you later.